Hi, I'm Lindsay here with Alec and Casey at the 86th Annual Royal Agricultural Winter Fair.
The Royal is famous for attracting hundreds of thousands of visitors and always bringing the country to the city each year.
Today we'll be discussing the local food movement and its impact on Ontario.
Hi, I'm with Dr. Mary Buer, an animal science professor, here at the Royal Agricultural Winter Fair to talk about locally grown food. How do you feel about locally grown food in Ontario?
I'm hugely supportive of it. It's what I do myself is buy locally as much as I can. I love farmers markets, but it's also so great to be able to be supporting the people who are actually growing the food and doing it well. It's a great idea.
In terms of the urban population, how do you feel that locally grown food, in a sense, educates them towards Ontario agriculture?
When people start buying locally, they're thinking about where the food comes from, and that means they start to think about what it takes to produce the food, what it takes to get the food to them, and what it is actually involved in having food on their table, as opposed to just going to the grocery store and whipping it off the shelves.
What else can be done to promote locally grown food in Ontario?
We need to be mounting a serious education campaign that talk to people about why it's good to buy locally and emphasizing the quality, also emphasizing the savings in terms of transportation, fuel, all of those kinds of things that are the additional benefits of buying local.
I'm here with Dr. Rob McLaughlin, president of the Royal Agricultural Winter Fair. Thanks for having us.
Delighted that you're here.
How do you feel about the local food movement?
Oh, I think it's wonderful. It's an opportunity for the public to actually come to an agriculture agenda instead of us having to go to them to try and convince them that what we're doing is good stuff. They're actually demanding local food, which is what we do.
So where do you see the local food movement going in the future?
Oh, I think it's going to grow. One of the real issues for me is there's a lot of stuff that's local that gets into processed foods or manufactured foods, and because right now people's minds, local is fresh, farmers markets, that kind of thing. And yet when you go into the grocery store, there's just a tremendous amount of stuff that's in cans and microwavable things and all those kinds of, it's all grown locally. Consumers don't just make that connection, and somehow we've got to do a better job of that.
All right, thanks very much.
Hi, I'm here with Jamie Rayom, the Executive Director of the Holland Marsh Growers Association. Jamie, how do you feel locally grown food affects agriculture in Ontario?
Well, we've got a slogan that says, harvested in the morning for your table that night. Behind us, we're giving out free 1-pound bags of carrots. We've gone through 20,000 in the space of 3 days. Now, that doesn't seem like a lot when you look at the numbers, but what we're trying to do is bring people back in touch with where their food comes from. We want people to be aware that there are store crops throughout the year that they can get. Carrots, onions, potatoes, turnips, rutabagas. The entire list is very large. And what we're trying to do is bring that back to the consumer and say, you know what, this is available.
I'm here with Lois Ferguson, manager of the Journey to Your Good Health Pavilion. How do you feel about the local food movement?
It's very exciting, and what we find here with visitors at the Royal Winter Fair, they love to see what we're doing to promote local food. They love to meet the farmers, pick up recipes, and then they become converts or supporters of local. We even have a woman who's a locavore, and so she promotes local food. People come and answer questions. She gives them prizes. It's fun.
Okay, so where do you see the local food movement going in the future?
Local food's is a movement that is here to stay. And I think what we're finding, for example, at the Royal, is making local foods to suit various cultures and also promoting the health benefits of local food. That's very, very important.
Hi, I'm here with John Drummond, past president of 4-H Ontario. John, how do you feel about the local food movement?
I'm a big believer in it, not just to save on transportation costs and fuel costs, that kind of thing, but just to support the local agricultural economy.
In your opinion, how do you think locally grown food affects urban populations?
Farmers feed cities, and that's the most important message that we have to get across, make people in the cities realize that.
So there you have it. Clearly, locally grown food is on everyone's minds.
And with all the display and excitement, the Royal is a perfect place to promote locally grown food.
So the next time you go to the grocery store, pick Ontario freshness.
Good things grow in Ontario.
Good things grow
in Ontario.
Good things grow in Ontario.
Good things grow in Ontario.
Hooray for Ontario.